Today at the House of Hacks, we're gonna go from this to this. Hi makers, builders, and do-it-yourselfers, Harley here. In a previous video, I explained how to convert 8-foot long fluorescent fixtures from fluorescent tubes to LED lights in a very quick and easy way. However, this way it was pretty expensive. It involved just getting some ready-made 8-foot LED lights, and those things are really pricey. For some reason, the 8-foot LED tube replacements are a whole lot more expensive than 2 4-foot LED replacement tubes. The 8-foot tube replacements are $60 each, whereas I picked up a 4-pack of 4-foot ones for $24. I have no idea why, and they've been this way for quite a while. I picked up 2 pair last year, I think it was, and they were $60. I just picked up 2 pair yesterday and they're still $60. Same price, it hasn't moved at all. And it's pretty much the same price whether you buy it online or retail like I did. Usually there's a few dollars off buying them online, but of course you have shipping and handling costs added to it, so it ends up being a wash. It's a real quick way to do it because you don't need to replace ballast, you don't need to rewire anything, you can just plug them in replacement of the existing bulbs. So it's really quick, it's more expensive getting the bulbs that are designed for ballast. However, in the 4-foot market, you can buy tubes that work either with ballast or without ballast. And I have a fixture that needs some work on it. The ballast is making noise and the tubes are flickering, and so I wanted to replace them with LEDs. But because the ballast is making noise, I wanted to do a ballast bypass and remove the ballast altogether. And so I'm going to be demonstrating that in today's video. It is a little bit more work because you have to take the ballast out and rewire things a little bit, but it's not a whole lot more work, and you do remove one more component that could possibly fail on you. So let's get started. First, remove the old bulbs. It'd probably be a good idea to turn off the power before doing this. Yeah, do as I say, not as I do. Now take the fixture down. This will vary depending on how it's installed. In my case, it's just sitting between the joists on some 2x4s. Next, disconnect the mains power. Be sure to have the power turned off. You don't want to be working with live power at this point. On the bench, the fixture needs to be opened up. This will vary depending on the type of lamp you have. In my case, it's just a matter of removing 2 nuts. And then the case just opens up. Here we see where the sockets are connected to the ballast. Since we're removing the ballast, all these connectors get taken apart. We need to do this on both sides of the fixture. And we need to remove the mains wire from the ballast input. Once all the electrical connections are separated, we can physically remove the ballast. In this case, there are 2 screws with nuts on them. Other designs may have a single sheet metal screw on one side and a slot on the other. Now we need a short piece of wire to run from the center where the mains are connected to one end of the fixture. I'm using some scrap 14-2 TPS cable I had in the parts bin. If you have to buy some, 3 feet should be plenty. Now I prepare all the ends by stripping off about 3/4 of an inch of the insulation from each wire and twisting the strands so they don't fray as easily. I also strip the insulation from the 14-2 cable. Now comes the most technical part of this project. Here we see each socket has 2 wires coming out of it. On one end of the fixture, we want to connect 1 wire from each socket to the white wire and the other one to the black wire. It's probably easiest to see in this pictorial diagram. Hit pause on the video if you need to study this. Because I have 4 sockets on this fixture, I used some pigtails to keep from having a huge number of wires all in one wire nut. When it's all put together, it looks like this. The sockets on the other end of the fixture don't need any connection. I just put wire nuts over the ends of the wires to keep them from potentially shorting anything out, and then zip tied them together to keep them neat and tidy. Finally, I stripped the insulation back from the other end of the 14-2 cable. We can see here I'm not using the copper ground wire from the new cable, but the existing ground that goes to the fixture. And now it's a matter of reassembling the fixture and reconnecting the mains. Again, make sure the power is off before doing this. Reinstall the fixture. In my case, it's just a matter of dropping it back into place between the joists. Finally, install the bulbs. These particular bulbs have only one end that connects to the sockets with power. So if they don't work the first time, turn the bulbs around end for end. Turn on the power and enjoy your new lights. So give me a thumbs up if you found that helpful. I really appreciate it. And I really thank you for joining me on this continuing creative journey that we're on. Until next time, go make something. Perfection's not required, fun is.